Dominick Cruz versus Henry Cejudo. Oh, this was the fight Cejudo wanted, right? You know, he gets to go around. I mean, I'm going with him in this fight. All day, absolutely taking Cejudo in this fight, right? I mean, I definitely think he's going to come out with the victory. To be perfectly honest, I think he's going to stop him. I think he gets Cruz out of there. Don't think he's going to make it five rounds. And this is the fight that he wanted. I mean, think about this. Think about what he's going to have here on his resume. If he comes away with the victory after this fight, he's going to go from Demetrius Johnson. And then who did he have? Was it directly after that fight that he went to Dillashaw? Then right after that, he goes to Marlon Moraes. And now he's going to turn around and get Dominick Cruz. Think about that if he gets that, those last four fights, and what that's going to mean. Just the domination down to 125 and 135. And obviously the run that he went on before he even got to the Demetrius Johnson fight, because that was a title fight. So he racked up wins before that. I can't even recall who it was that he fought in that run before he got those. On top of the Olympic gold medal. Ooh, man, that's an impressive... Man, that is a resume. Man, that is a resume. But yeah, I think he's gonna get the victory in this one. Okay, and I'll tell you why. So much of Dominick Cruz's game. Number one, obviously, it's no secret, built off of the footwork. His footwork is very awkward, very crazy. He comes in, he's always feinting. You don't know exactly what he's gonna do. He works these great angles, smooth, fast. On top of that, he mixes in good upper body movement. And he ends up throwing punches from crazy angles on top of it, right? His punches aren't always straight. Sometimes, you know, they're looping and wide and things like that. He mixes in good kicks. And here's the other thing that's really key. He mixes in takedowns. He gets a lot of takedowns, right? He comes from a collegiate wrestling background. So it's no secret that he has good wrestling. And when you throw in all the confusion and he's just a master of distance and timing and stuff with those angles. He's able to get his takedowns easily. He gets really good entries. Sometimes he'll use them as counter. Sometimes he'll be aggressive with them, and he gets guys down, right? So very well-rounded fighter, comes in, executes beautifully, right? Handful for anybody, particularly when you look about how long this guy's been around and the fact that he was doing it at a time when the game was just less evolved. I mean, let's be honest, since he stepped into the game, he's been around for a long time, and since he stepped in to the UFC even, you know, the game has evolved and changed a lot, you know? So it was really something else when he was coming out there early on in his career doing it, right? It was really, really a handful for guys. But that's not really the case anymore. He's a little bit different of a fighter today. And on top of that, Henry Cejudo is something special. That man knows how to fight, for one. But the reason I say he's a little bit different is because he slowed down a little bit. Okay, we saw it in his fight with Cody Garbrandt. Okay, see, here's the thing. Timing beats speed. Every single time. If you have great timing, you will beat great speed. Okay, the most perfect boxing example that I can think about is Juan Manuel Marquez versus Manny Pacquiao. Juan Manuel Marquez was a master counterpuncher. Phenomenal timing. He wasn't nearly the athlete that Pacquiao was. Not nearly. Okay? He didn't have the speed that Pacquiao had. But he didn't need it. When you have great timing, you can counter that. Okay? And it's the same thing. It was the same thing with Cody Garbrandt. Cody Garbrandt had great timing. On top of that, Cruz had slowed down a little bit, so he was able to catch him. He wasn't able to get in and out of those angles quite as much. When he does the things that weren't technically good, because Cruz comes, when he backs up, he holds his head up a lot. He'll back out of things straight back with his head up. But a lot of times he was fast enough to be able to pull that off. He was able to get away from guys. They took a swing anyways. They saw the opening, but they weren't quick enough to be able to capitalize on it. Garbrandt was able to capitalize on a couple of those as Cruz was slowing down. Besides, Garbrandt had really good timing back from his amateur boxing days. You could tell. So he was able to handle that a lot better. You know, and I think it's even going to be more so when he steps into this fight with Cejudo. Okay, so, because here's the thing. Henry Cejudo is ridiculously explosive. Okay, ridiculously explosive. Incredibly agile. But he's also patient. So he knows how to wait. He's going to come in. He's light on his feet. He's moving around. He's going to be able to get the timing of Cruz. I mean, I'm not saying like instantly, right? Like in the first 10 seconds, he's going to peg him or anything. Not, you know, nothing crazy like that. But he's going to. He's going to get that timing. okay, and he's going to explode, and he throws straight punches, and they're hard punches, and he's going to be able to catch Cruz. He's also going to be able to catch him with counters because he's got really fast hands. So as Cruz is coming in and trying to land stuff, and Cejudo gets his time because he's an intelligent fighter, he's going to be able to counter him, and he's going to hit him, and he's going to hurt him. You know, Cruz takes down almost all of his opponents, a lot of times, multiple times in the fight. He's not going to be taking down Henry Cejudo. Not Henry Cejudo, the gold medalist, the Olympic wrestler. Not that guy. He's not going to take Cejudo down. As a matter of fact, the roles are going to be reversed. I expect in this fight, Cejudo is going to put Dominick Cruz on his back. And that's something that we're really not used to seeing, and that's something that Cruz really isn't used to experiencing. You know, and on top of that, Henry Cejudo's got really, you know, surprise, surprise, he's got strong top control. It's dominant, right? So once he gets guys down, he's able to hold them down, you know? He just brings a lot to the table, man. He knows he's patient. He knows how to wait and explode. He knows how to bring pressure. I mean, look at the knees when he got inside on the rice that he was landing. I mean, think about it. He handled the speed and the timing and the footwork and the angles of Demetrius Johnson. Got takedowns on him. He handled the speed and the power and the size of a guy like Moraes. Knocked him out. And go back and watch that first round again. Man, Moraes had him in trouble. I thought he was out of there. I was like, phew. Marlon Moraes showed up tonight. He's landing these hard shots. Look like he's hurt, right? You know, so Hulu's ankle looks all funny very early on, like he rolled it or something, and his foot isn't responding correctly. I mean, it wasn't pretty. He came back and got the stoppage on that. You know, he took TJ Dillashaw and smoked him. Right? I mean, the man is, he's very impressive, you know. And I just think, I think he's going to go in there. I think he's really going to shine in this fight. Throw another thing in there that is not, should not be underestimated. Cruz hasn't fought in 3.5 years. I mean, he may not believe in ring rust, but I do. You know, especially when you're talking about a guy like Cejudo. It's just that timing, that feel, everything that comes along with that at fighting at that absolute world-class level. You can't replicate that in training. You can try as much as you can, and you can mentally prepare yourself, and I get it. You know, Dominick Cruz is incredibly mentally strong. I really like him as a fighter. I take nothing from him. I know he's going to come and he's going to be 100% prepared, but it's just not quite the same as when you're used to stepping in there all the time. It's just not. You know, there's going to be that little bit of difference. You know, that little bit of time that you need to adjust against the man who's in there doing it all the time, constantly. So, he may not believe in ring rust, but I do. He hasn't been in there for 3.5 years. You know, he's got the injuries that has been going on. I mean, that's what's contributing to the slowdown on top of it. So, you know, I think this fight, I don't think he should have got this fight in the first place. A title shot after not fighting in 3.5 years. Like, there's not people in the division that are already justified to get it. Jan, Aljamain Sterling, Corey Sandhagen even. I mean, there's guys out there. So, I wasn't really keen on him getting this fight, being able to step off the bench 3.5 years. He gets a shot at the title. Not really a fan of that. You know, but okay, whatever. But, you know, more power to him. He's an all-time great, but I think he's going to come up short in this one. This is one that I would put some money on because of the simple fact that I don't think that he's going to be able to outpoint Cejudo. I don't think he's going to be able to get him anywhere. And he doesn't have the power to be able to make up and come back if he's down on points late in the fight. He's not a great submission artist or anything like that. I don't see him being able to, like, eke out the last round or the last two rounds by being able to take Cejudo down and hold him down and all of a sudden, you know, getting an ugly victory at the end on points or something. I don't see any of that happening, right? I look at this as Cejudo has the ability to beat Cruz at his game, at Cruz's game, and he can beat him the way that other ways that he wants to beat him. So I look at this as being a very dominant victory. Cejudo coming out there, you know, and really making it happen. So I definitely, you know, would feel comfortable. So I put something on this one. You know, a lot of other fights on this card, it can, you know, they're a little bit more going either way. But this one, Cejudo all day long. So as always, you know, let me know what you think in the comments. Let me know who you think is going to come away with this one, and who may be next for him. Whoever were to come away with the victory in this one, who do you think would be next for them? Who would be next in line? Would it happen on Fight Island? How is it all going to play out? Either way, it should be a great fight. Both guys always show up 100%, so it should be awesome.